For something called a bomber, I was hoping for a little more.
Oh, you were expecting to be on the floor. Just fucking totaled, right?
Well, I guess I'm just going to have to drink this whole can.
Are you going to chug it? Oh, okay. You're not going to enjoy it. Come on, man. You okay?
Drink. Eins, zwei, drei, vier. Lift your stein and drink your beer.
Eins, zwei, drei, vier. Lift your stein and drink your beer. Drink.
When you're hanging out with your friends
and there's nothing to do but get shit-faced,
that means it's alcohol time.
Yeah. No hat?
No, I don't do hats.
Why not? Sombrero? Come on. I'm sure you'll just edit it.
Anyways, it's time for not just any alcohol. It's gonna be a British invasion. I got some... Apparently it's British beer.
See, I didn't know it was British, and I'm drinking a Sicilian beer. So,
well, anyways,
some info, man. Come on.
See, I dropped my guest star here without any sort of clue into what beer he's drinking. He doesn't know what he's getting into. It might be the worst beer he's ever tasted. It might be the best beer he's ever tasted.
Right now it's Sicilian, so.
Obviously, my scale, this is how we rate things on the show, 1 to 10. Oh, actually, 0 to 10. 0 is the worst beer you've ever had, or alcohol, and 10 is the best alcohol you've ever had of that kind. So
right now, I'd say Budweiser is probably one of the worst ones. For a while, I liked it, but...
No. But you liked it at one point. So wouldn't that mean that's about maybe a 3 out of 10?
But then I tried other ones and I liked those more. So, I mean.
See, that's an example of adjusting the scale according to what beers you have. So let me go grab the British beer. Dropping. Incoming.
Oh, the bomber.
The Lancaster Bomber.
Where'd you get this one?
I have no fucking idea.
All right.
Are you ready?
I thought maybe it was Spitfire.
I know. When you said Spitfire, I almost said, well, you're close, because the Spitfire is a kind of plane. Lancaster Bomber, I assume,
well,
is another plane.
Spitfire is also a beer, too.
Exactly.
I just can't find it anywhere.
Well.
They used to have it in Georgetown, but...
This is apparently, it's a British beer. Best of British. Full-bodied amber ale.
All right.
Down the hatches.
All right, cheers, mate.
Cheers.
Yeah. Actually hold it there to get the flavor, right?
Mm-hmm.
Smooth.
Yeah?
Very smooth. And light, too.
It's
not very strong.
Reminds me a lot of, like...
That makes sense. It's only 4.5%.
Oh, it's not even 5%. Jeez. Yeah. For something called a bomber, I was hoping for a little more.
Oh, you were expecting to be on the floor. Just fucking totaled, right?
Well, I guess I'm just going to have to drink this whole can.
Are you going to chug it? Oh, okay. You're not going to enjoy it. Come on, man. You okay? Want me to get you water?
I got water on the
Fuck, buddy. Did I make you laugh at the wrong moment or something?
Yes, you did. Don't do that at home, kids. I'm having flashbacks to my first drink.
I certainly hope kids aren't getting the Lancaster bomber, because...
That's bad.
Yeah. Pops won't be happy.
Oh, man. Don't do alcohol, kids. You'll end up like me. Oh, gosh.
Oh, that's very nice. I like that.
It is only with you.
Is this a premium?
I have no idea. I'm glad I was able to buy it where individually instead of a six-pack.
I gotta tilt my head to read it because otherwise I'm going to put it all over your fucking floor.
Well, yeah, you just don't tilt the can sideways to read it. And then. Why is it only with you that the alcohol ends up going through my nose?
I don't know.
Every other time I drink, it's only when you're here.
Because I have this habit of making you laugh right when you go to drink.
Oh, damn it.
The same thing with the gin.
Oh, the gin.
They even give you a daily recommended dosage. So for men, they're for men they're saying 3 to 4 units daily, and for women it's 2 to 3 because they're lightweights. I'm gonna get so much shit for that. But anyways.
Oh, is that shots fired? I hear over there.
Yeah. Well, comments are gonna be like misogynistic pig, you know, and all this other wonderful stuff.
Anyways, you're gonna cut that out. Well, that's the power of editing.
He probably won't. I'm gonna look like the biggest asshole on the internet.
You're just trying to, you're trying to get me laugh again. No, I will say the,
no, I wouldn't do that.
I will say the beer hits harder when it goes through your nose.
Does it burn?
Not, not no, the no, the gin was the worst.
Well, yeah, that's like 40%. No, it was 42%.
It was 45.
I'm pretty sure it's 42.
Aviation gin was 45, I'm
get
pretty
sure.
Get
the bottle, I think it's 42. Let's see whose
memory's
better.
We got rid of the bottle because we finished it.
I don't know, man. I think it's 42.
We can't remember.
I'm going to look this up. I got to know.
Oh, here we go.
I think it's 42, buddy.
Well, anyways. After, you know, because it's been a while since I've had a beer. Last beer I had was Heineken, and that was pretty good, but... This one's pretty smooth. The more you drink it, the smoother it gets.
I don't know if you can see that, mate, but
it's 45.
No,
yeah,
that's 42.
Yeah,
it's
no,
shit.
Cut that out, Kara.
No,
well,
you can't
see 42.
That. Yeah.
See, I can edit it. I have the power here.
Yeah.
Oh, sounds like Gondor's calling for aid.
I eat a lot of brain food. I eat a lot of fish, so. My memory is pretty good, despite the fact that I'm an alcoholic, but, you know, whatever.
I've had, with this beer, I've noticed the more you drink it, the better it gets.
That's usually how it goes.
Yeah, but with the other beers,
also,
I haven't had
that
experience.
The more beer you drink, the less ugly the women at the bar look.
Oh, gosh, really? And this is just in. Curtis is no longer allowed on my channel. You know, my YouTube viewership, I think I have, like, maybe even 2% women out of
100%.
Well,
it's the same thing for women.
Well, now it's down to 0%.
It's the same thing for women. Like, they have 3 of these, you know, pop them back. That ugly fucker at the bar, he's looking pretty good now, right?
Okay, I hold no responsibility for what anyone says on this show.
Well, I'm sure you'll just, like, blur it out.
From 0 to 10, from all the beers you've ever had.
Compared to all the beers I've had?
Yeah, you had, yeah. So this is a personal rating to your scale of beer. Looks like he needs more testing. I, on the other hand, I think I got a pretty definitive score. This is a 7.5 out of 10.
Pretty high score.
I know. At first, I wasn't going to go that high, but the more I'm
it
having
even went
it...
through your nose, man.
That might have affected my brain cells, if we're being honest here. That might have rigged it. It didn't hurt me as much, though I did feel like I was drowning at one point.
Well, I find it very smooth, and it's not too strong. So I would say probably... Well, it is a matter of opinion, because some people like it strong.
Yeah.
And some people like blonde beers, and some people like darker ones.
Think of it as, like, a mixture of favorite and best.
Okay,
In the sense that, like, for example, for me, my scale, my 0 currently right now is a blue raspberry IPA. That was the worst beer I ever had.
I would never even drink that.
Someone
passes that shit to me, put it in the fridge and bury it. I don't ever want to look at it again. Okay?
Yeah, and then number 10 for me was just recently at a barbecue. I had... believe it was Bud Light Pink. It was strawberry lemonade beer. And that was the best beer I've ever had.
That's not fucking beer, people.
Oh, here we go.
And pour that shit down the drain. It's not beer.
So this is actually just above Heineken in my rating system.
Okay.
Corona was like a 5.
I guess I could use Heineken as a benchmark.
So Heineken's your 5? Out of 10?
No, it's actually my favorite.
Oh, so it's like, that would be your 10 out of 10 then?
I'd say a 9, but... An 8? I'd go with an 8.
Mmm.
Yeah.
Pretty good. I mean, you don't have to like the beer. I mean, just because I bought it for you doesn't mean you have to like it, you know? Don't feel obligated.
Well, I'll take any beer that's free, you know?
Well, wait until the next one.
Yeah.
So right. Finish it up, and then we got round two.
Okay.
Mystery beer.
Now, is this a dark or is this another blonde? Did you get variety?
This is Iron Maiden beer.
Oh. A little stronger.
Iron Maiden British beer.
All right.
Gotta get that nice focus on it. Look at that. Iron Maiden beer.
Is this a pale or a dark? It doesn't say.
I don't know.
Like blonde or dark? Like
blonde? I just screwed up the focus. Like, see, this is what happens when you try filming
focus,
drunk.
Focus, you fuck!
Anyway. Yeah, so it's charged with flavor, and it's a beer, apparently, and I'm like, I had to get it. It's called Trooper, and it's created by Iron Maiden. So the band was like, we're awesome, let's create our own beer. Are you ready to crack it?
I was reading.
Who reads their beer?
Iron Maiden vocalist Bruce Dickinson worked with Robinson's to develop a beer which had true depth of character. malt flavors and citric notes from a unique blend of Barbec, Goldings, and Cascade hops. Cascade. What?
So there's the backstory.
Dominate this deep golden ale with the subtle hint of lemon.
Are you done?
No.
Okay, I'm
okay,
cracking
so
this.
Okay, so it's a golden ale, so it'd be lighter then. And it's got lemon, hints of lemon. Tell me if you can taste the lemon. Now don't just chug the bloody thing, alright?
Not with you around.
You need to hold it, lad, in your throat there.
Cheers.
Don't let it get in your nose.
You're going to make me laugh again. All it's right, going to go in right. My nose again.
Cheers, cheers.
Cheers.
Okay. Not the nose. Okay.
It's pretty lighter compared to the other one.
No, it's actually stronger by about 2 points.
Well, yeah, but it tastes like the initial taste of the other one felt stronger than this.
I got a hint of the lemon, but it's not overpowering. Obviously.
Oh, no, I'm tasting it now.
The lemon?
The beer. You're just like... If there's any clue that I don't know what I'm doing, this is it.
You don't get the lemon?
No, that must be the thing that's dulling it. Like, it takes the edge off a little bit. Like, it's a little hint of edge off.
Just a little.
Just a little. Okay. That's what I'm getting out of this beer.
Well, I like it.
Yeah, it's only 4.
But not as much as the Lancaster. Simply because I don't like lemons. The other one seems smoother to me. And I don't like acidic things, and lemons are kind of acidic, right?
So yeah. Any sort of fruity drink, Curtis is like, ugh!
Well, no, sweet's okay, but your beer shouldn't taste like fucking cranberries. Like.
Well,
I mean, what is it, your period?
Oh, God.
Yeah, we're...
Well, it's like The Departed is like, because he orders a cranberry, and he's like, what are you?
A cranberry drink? Yeah.
Yeah, so next time Curtis comes over, we're going to be reviewing Strawberry Lemonade Bud Light.
No.
Yeah. I'll get the most fruity drink I can think of.
I would give this a 6. I like the...
Oh, you're already reviewing
eh? I like the Lancaster more.
You're not going to let it sit with you? You're not going to...
No, I don't like fucking lemons. So.
Make your way through this?
I don't
But
like
yeah,
lemons.
The lemon surprisingly... Like, the more I drink, the more I taste the lemon. And the lemon is... It's dulling the beer, in a sense, for me.
Yeah, I don't
like where the Lancaster was got better the more I drink it. The more I'm drinking this, the more I feel like I'm drinking the lemon.
That's probably because I mentioned lemon.
Well, that's the thing.
If I didn't mention lemon, he would have no fucking idea.
I would be like, what is that mystery flavor? Because in the beginning, I tried to describe what it was that was like affecting the beer. But the more I think about it, I think you planted the idea in my head that it's lemon. Lemon is affecting it.
Like, I get the lemon after... Like, there's an aftertaste of lemon, right? But, I mean, the initial taste, it's not as smooth as the Lancaster either, right?
Yeah, the more I'm drinking this, the more I'm like, I like the Lancaster.
The Lancaster's smoother.
Mm-hmm.
And this has a sharp, acidic taste, aftertaste, because of the lemon, I think. I don't really like
it. But don't get me wrong, this is a...
I mean, it's okay.
For me, this is a solid 6 out of 10.
It's better than Budweiser, I'll say that.
It's better than Corona, I'll say that.
I haven't tried Corona.
Yeah, so... Yeah. My mistake with my first Corona, which is actually the first beer I ever had, is I didn't try it with the lime.
You're supposed to have it with the lime, right?
Oh, I love how...
I don't fucking like limes either. See, I'd hate probably Corona. I wouldn't like Corona.
Well, apparently, if you take a Corona and add the lime, it makes it better. And I'm like, how does lime make a... don't get me wrong, Corona was to me, it's the 5 out of 10. It's the middle point for beers, in my opinion, from what I've tasted.
Lemon and limes, I don't like them.
Yeah. To be honest, if it wasn't for the blue raspberry beer, Corona would have probably been my zero.
See, I won't even drink that. You give me that shit, it's like, what the fuck?
The worst part is I forgot what the name of the beer was. I think it was like Stubble or something like that, and it had a really fancy can design. Yeah, I didn't like that. I would rate this a 6 out of 10. It's a Iron Maiden made a solid beer, but there's much better ones in my opinion. Like the Lancaster Bomber.
Well, again, it's all opinion. Opinions are like assholes. Everyone has one. But my opinion is I don't...
Truer words were never
spoken. My opinion is this one's just above a 5. It's just above average. But, I mean, I don't like lemons. So, I mean, if I like lemons, this would be like a 9, you know? I'd be like, holy shit. Lemon-flavored beer. I'd be like, I've died and gone to heaven, man.
I kind of wish you didn't mention lemon, because like that's all I'm thinking about now.
I do like the artwork, though.
Well, it's Iron Maiden, isn't it? Yeah. You got the Trooper, Eddie holding the flag.
Who doesn't like Iron Maiden?
I wonder what other bands have created other drinks, alcoholic drinks. Can you imagine something? Like, take like a really poppy band, their version of the alcohol, and then a metal band, and then their version of the
metal
alcohol.
Metal band, it would taste like rusty nails and death. Poppy band would probably be like bubble gum and I don't know.
It would be funny if it's the opposite and the more pop related the band, the more stronger and deadlier like the alcohol is.
Pop is just cancer.
Well, I guess that sort of wraps things up for this episode.
He didn't like the gin.
Okay, a gin, to clarify, I liked Aviation Gin. It was the
Have
only
you tried a gin and
it
tonic?
It was the only gin I've ever had. I don't think I've ever tried a gin and tonic. I had a martini. Is that gin?
It's made with gin sometimes, yeah.
Well, there you go. I had a martini in Jamaica. But,
Shaken, not stirred?
I forgot what they
Darcy.
Did.
Mitchell Darcy?
I just asked for a martini. They did whatever.
You asked for it made with gin?
I don't...
See, I've gone to bars and I'm like, I'll have a martini made with gin.
See,
they're like, what kind of gin? And I'm like, Aviation Gin. And they're like, what? And I'm like, Aviation Gin. Shaken.
And then Ryan Reynolds walks in and be like, here you go.
Yeah.
He's always on standby whenever you order Aviation Gin. In my honest, gin and vodka are very similar. The difference is gin is a lot more burning. Like, instant. Like, if you put that in your throat, it's instant burn if you're drinking it straight up.
I think it's like drinking perfume.
I can see that with the smell a bit, but the vodka's better, I feel.
It's got like a flowery flavor. It's like I'm eating goddamn flowers.
Anyways, thank you very much for watching. I want you to have a nice day or night or whatever time you watch this. Have a nice Iron Maiden or Lancaster beer.
Like, comment, and subscribe down below.
I didn't even tell him to say that, and he freaking says it. I never say that in my videos. I mean, I've said it a couple times.
It's a given, man. Like, how are you gonna grow?
Well,
the audience?
I figure it would be cool to be natural and just not, you know, push it because everybody. Says that. Yeah, everyone says that. I want to be different, man.
Push that shit.
I don't want to push that shit.
Push it real good.
Okay, fine. I'll push it. Okay, so do what he says, or I'll find you. What a good place to be. Don't believe I.